It's Philippines versus Japan. Wushu versus striking. Eustaquio, the former world champion, the shorter. Here's the elder. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in a one flyweight world Grand Prix reserve contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is a Pancrase flyweight tournament champion, standing at 168 centimeters tall, holding a mixed martial arts record of 10 wins and 4 losses. Training out of Tribe Tokyo MMA, representing Japan, he is Yuya Little Piranha Wakamatsu. And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 163 centimeters tall, holding a wushu record of 38 wins and 2 losses. Training out of Team Lakai and representing the Philippines. Put your hands together for the former one flyweight world champion, Geje Gravity Eustaquio. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Kemp Chen.
No, here about don't get a back to the head, watch your logo, don't grab the ropes. Touch the glove. Back to the corner.
Final instructions from our referee, Kemp Chen. It's the one championship tournament. Heroes live from Manila in the Philippines. Big hello to David in Northern Ireland, watching one championship for the first time. They bound out of their corners. Eustaquio, the former world champion. Wakamatsu, a cagey character, full of tricks. You never know what Wakamatsu is going to throw. Eustaquio, a brilliant wushu stylist. Look out for the fast hands, look out for the side kicks, look out for the spinning back fists on Geje Eustaquio.
One thing we know Wakamatsu is going to throw is that giant right hand he's got. Utilized it beautifully against Demetrius Johnson, against Danny Kingad. Nice and light on his feet, bouncing in and out. Geje's nice and relaxed. There he goes, chopping at the legs now with that wushu style sidekick.
Right hand right from Geje, and lethal left hand just missed the target for Eustaquio. But his crowd on the edge of their seats expecting something extraordinary from Eustaquio.
And his chin a little bit tucked there. You can see when he's moving backwards, he starts to pop that chin up. That right hand lands on the chin, though.
High up on the balls of his feet here is Yuya Wakamatsu. Left hook right hand from Wakamatsu. Didn't have the distance. Overhand right from Eustaquio, going for the headache maker. Eustaquio edging forward, gets out of the way, just evades the left hand of Wakamatsu. Body shot from Wakamatsu. Turning back kick from Eustaquio. Now what the wushu guys from Team Lakai will tend to do with that spinning back kick is to aim it towards the liver of the opponent. So just around below the right rib cage, towards the stomach area, the large target that is only partly protected by the ribs, being the liver. Eustaquio tip kick. Oh, this one's over. That is huge. He told you, you never know what Yuya Wakamatsu is going to throw. And Geje Eustaquio did not see that coming.
Told you he was going to throw that right hand, though, Michael Cervello.
Yeah, you did, Mitch. You called it.
Yuya Wakamatsu getting right back into it. Beautifully timed right hand comes over the top, lands in a couple of punches. We got to see a look at again at that one. Yuya Wakamatsu bounces back perfectly. Check this out. Geje gets caught with his chin up in the air. Yuya Wakamatsu comes right down the middle and connects with a beautiful right hand to get a big knockout of a very established veteran. That's a huge victory for Yuya Wakamatsu, Michael.
That is massive to knock out the former world champion. in highlights reel fashion. Yuya Wakamatsu over Geje Eustaquio. Not a good night for the team Philippines so far here in Manila. Can they turn it around in our main card? Let's go to Dom Lau and make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 59 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Yuya Wakamatsu!
Yuya Wakamatsu, first round knockout, and there is the show of respect. There is a moment between two superb athletes. And there's the winner's medal. It goes back to Japan, around the neck of the little piranha whose bite was hard tonight.